Now we'll study about wedge constrained motions. For wedge constraints, we can say when our body moves over another body, under some constraint rules, then such motion are called wedge constrained motions. In case of wedge constrained motions also, we develop constraint relations by relating their displacements. Like for a simple example, if we see on smooth ground, say we are having a plank A over which another block B is placed, and they are connected by a pulley which is attached to the side wall like this. Now say block A is pulled with a force F. We can directly state if A will be displaced toward right by a distance X. Obviously B will move toward left, say it will move toward left by a distance Y. We can say as the string is ideal, if it is inextensible, the distance by which A goes toward right, the same distance B should move toward left. So here we can say displacement Y is equals to displacement X. So at every instant of time, velocity of B is equals to velocity of A, and acceleration of B is equals to acceleration of A. So these are the constraint relations which we develop in such cases. There can be more cases related to similar situations. Let's see those. Let us analyze similar type of situation in wedge constraints. Say we are having a triangular wedge block A over which another block B is placed connected to a string, and the other end of a string passes through a pulley and attached to the other side of the left wall. In this situation, if A block moves toward left with a velocity V, certainly B will slide down. As it goes toward left, length of string on this part will reduce and on the other part will increase, so B must slide down. Say we consider block A goes toward left by a distance X, B slides down by a distance Y. Now in this situation we can say when this triangular wedge displaces to the left by a distance X, you can see the length of a string on this part will reduce by X. So obviously it will increase on the other side by X. So B has to slide down by the same distance X. So in this situation we can state Y is certainly be equal to X. So we differentiate it, velocity of block B can be again written as velocity of block A, that is equals to V. But B is sliding on the surface of A. So this velocity is the velocity of block B relative to wedge A, as it is also moving along with A toward left. So we can simply state as we have studied earlier, if it is moving down with the velocity V, making an angle theta with the horizontal, in X direction its velocity will be V cos theta, and in Y direction its velocity will be V sin theta, that is relative to wedge, and it is also moving along with the wedge toward left with the velocity V. So in this situation for block B, we can write velocity in X direction will be toward left it is V, toward right it is V cos theta, so it must be V minus V cos theta, and its velocity in Y direction will be V sin theta. So net velocity of block B can be written as root of Vx square plus Vy square, which can be written as root of V 1 minus cos theta whole square plus V square sin square theta. If you open it, we'll get it as V square plus V square cos square theta, and V square sin square theta again becomes V square minus 2V square cos theta. Here we can take this V common out. This will be root of 2 minus 2 cos theta. On using half angle identity, 1 minus cos theta can be written as 2 sin square theta by 2. So this can be written as 2V sine theta by 2. Here this will be under the root, so it can be taken as 2V sine theta by 2.